In this video, we'll introduce RFF economic models that decision makers use to assess the impacts of climate policy proposals. First up, the Guler-Hafstead E3 model projects how federal emissions pricing policies affect the future. E3 is used to model congressional carbon pricing bills, which you can explore in RFF's carbon pricing calculator. We use other models to extend policy analysis beyond E3. To understand how carbon pricing policies affect unemployment, we turn to the EDGE model. Our social welfare incidence model assesses how carbon pricing policies affect different income groups. To understand the uncertainty of future emissions under carbon taxes, we pair E3 with our SEPT model, and we use our Dr. Gem model to evaluate regional emissions pricing policies. Next, let's look at how we model sectors of the economy. RFF has two models that simulate the effects of policies and investments on the U.S. electricity sector. Haiku simulates these effects at the state level, while East simulates them with exceptional geographic detail. In the transportation sector, the vehicle market model simulates the impacts of policies that affect vehicle markets, like fuel economy standards and changes in electric vehicle charging infrastructure. In the oil and gas sector, our Dogma model examines how U.S. drilling and production respond over time to price and policy fluctuations. And in the land sector, Calm simulates changes in agriculture, forestry, and other land uses under varying policies. Finally, let's consider models at the global scale. Our WICH model assesses climate change mitigation and adaptation policies, while ICES provides an economic assessment of climate change impacts and policies. And our GIVE model helps to improve estimates of the social cost of carbon, a metric used to account for climate damages in decision-making. RFF's SCC Explorer allows users to examine the GIVE model in more detail. Find out more about RFF's modeling capacities at rff.org/models.